Chapter 1. Geography. 1. Introduction. Everything available in our environment which can be used to satisfy our needs can be termed as a resource. Some conditions. Technologically accessible. Economically feasible. Culturally acceptable. Human beings interact with nature through technology and create institutions to accelerate economic development. Resources are a function of human activities. 2. Types of resources. Classification of resources. Origin. Exhaustibility. Ownership. Status of development. Origin. Biotic resources. Abiotic resources. 1. Biotic resources are resources derived from the biosphere, such as living things, and from forest and the materials derived from them. This mainly includes fossil fuels like petroleum, coal, and gas, etc. 2. Abiotic means other than living things, non-living things, example fresh air, land, heavy metal, etc. Exhaustibility. Renewable resources. Non-renewable resources. Renewable resources are those whose quantity is not reduced due to use and which can be repeatedly used without fear of exhaustion are termed as renewable resources. Example, wind, water, forests, etc. Non-renewable resources are substances whose stock gets reduced and are gradually exhausted with use are termed as non-renewable resource. They are exhaustible resources. Example, fossil fuels like coal, petroleum and minerals. Ownership. Individual, community, national, international. Resources, 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 resources. 1. Individual resources. Owned privately by individual, for example, plots, house, car, wells, etc. 2. Community resources, accessible to all the members of the community, for example, public parks, picnic spots, and playgrounds, etc. 3. National resources, technically, all the resources available in the country are national resources. For example, forests, wildlife land divisions, and political territories. 4. International resources. The oceanic resources beyond 200 kilometers of the exclusive economic zone belong to the international. Status of development. Potential developed stock reserves. 1. Potential, which have been found in a region but have not been yet utilized. 2. Developed, which are surveyed and their quality, quantity has been determined for utilization. 3. Stock, which have the potential to satisfy human needs, but they do not have appropriate technology to access them. 4. Reserves, can be put into use with the help of technical know-how, but their use has not been started. Development of resources. Major problems and need for sustainable development. Accumulation of resources in few hands, dividing the society in haves and have-nots. Indiscriminate use of resources leading to global warming, ozone layer depletion and environmental pollution, land degradation. Resource planning needed for sustainable existence of all forms of life. Sustainable economic development is the development that should take place without damaging the environment. The first International Earth Summit, held in Rio de Janeiro in 1992, attended by 100 countries, adopted Agenda 21 to achieve global sustainable development and to combat poverty, diseases from the world. Need for resource planning. There are regions which are rich in certain resources and deficient in some other resources. Arunachal Pradesh has abundance of water but lacks infrastructural development. Rajasthan has abundance of solar and wind energy but lack in water resources. Resources planning in India. A complex process is involving three processes. Identification and inventory of resources. Evolving a planning structure. Matching the resources development plan with national development plans. 5-year plans launched after independence. Indian resource development depends on technology, quality of human resources and historical experience of people. Conservation of resources. Vital for any development activity. Irrational consumption and overutilization lead to socio-economic and environmental problems. Land resources. Importance of land. Perform all economic activities on land. It's a natural resource supporting natural vegetation, wildlife, economic activates, and transport and communication system. An asset of a finite magnitude. Relief features. Variety relief features in India. Plains, covering 43% area. Mountains, covering 30% area. Plateaus, covering 27% area. Possesses rich resources in all these relief features. Land utilization. Forests. Land not available for cultivation. Barren and waste land. Permanent pastures and grazing land. Land under miscellaneous trees and cultural wastelands. Land resources. Land use pattern of India determined by both physical and human factors. Land use data available only for 93% area. Land degradation. Degraded land 130 million hectare, 28% forest degraded, 56% water eroded, certain human activities. Mining sites are abandoned. Overgrazing and over-irrigation is responsible for alkalinity. Mineral processing like cement industry, industrial effluents. Conservation of land. Deforestation and proper management of grazing lands. Planting of shelter boards. Control on overgrazing. Thorny bushes to stabilize sand dunes. Control on mining activities. Proper discharge and disposal of industrial effluents. Soil is a resource. Soil is the most important renewable natural resource. It is the medium of plant growth and supports different types of living organisms on the earth. Classification of soils. 1. Alluvial soil. I. The entire northern plains are made up of alluvial soils. 2. These have been deposited by this important Himalayan river system. Indus, Ganga, Brahmaputra. 3. Alluvial soil is also found in the eastern coastal plains, particularly in the deltas of Mahanadi River, Krishna River, Godavari River, Kaveri River. 4. The alluvial soil consists of various proportions of sand, silt and clay. V. Alluvial soil are described on the basis of their age. Old Bangor has higher concentration of kanker nodules, less fertile than Kadar. New Kadar has less concentration of kanker nodules than Bangor. Is more fertile than Bangor. 6. Mostly these soils contain adequate proportion of potash, phosphoric acid and lime, which are ideal. Edomate. For the growth of sugar cane, paddy, wheat and other cereal and pulse crops. Black soil. 1. These soils are black in color and are also known as regu soil. 2. They are ideal for growing cotton and is also known as black cotton soil. 3. This type of soil is typical of the Deccan trap basalt region, spread over northwest Deccan plateau and is made up of lava flows. 4. The black soils are made up of extremely fine, that is, clayey material. 5. These soils are strictly when wet and difficult to work on unless tilled immediately after the first shower or during the pre-monsoon period. Red and yellow soils. 1. Red soil develops on crystalline igneous rocks in areas of low rainfall in the eastern and southern parts of the Deccan Plateau. 2. Yellow and red soils are found in parts of Orissa, Chhattisgarh, southern parts of the Middle Ganga Plain and along the Piedmont zone of the Western Ghats. 3. These soils develop a reddish color due to diffusion of iron in crystalline and metamorphic rocks. Laterite soil 1. The laterite develops in areas with high temperature and heavy rainfall. 2. This soil is suitable for cultivation with adequate doses of manures and fertilizers. 3. These soils are mainly found in Karnataka, Kerala, Tamil Nadu. This soil is very useful for growing tea and coffee. Arid soils. 1. Arid soils range from red to brown in color. 2. They are generally sandy in texture and saline in nature. 3. In some areas the salt content is very high and common salt is obtained by evaporating the water. 4. The bottom layer of kanker restricts the infiltrating the water. 5. After proper irrigation these soils become cultivable as has been in the case of Western Rajasthan. Soil erosion 1. Denudation of soil cover and subsequent washing down is called soil erosion. 2. Due to human activities like deforestation, overgrazing, construction and mining. 3. Natural forces like wind, water, glacier and water lead to soil erosion. 4. Running water cuts through clayey soil and form gullies. 5. Also caused due to defective method of farming plowing in a wrong mower. Soil conservation 1. Plowing along contour lines, contour plowing. 2. Steps can be cut on slopes, terrace farming 3. Strips of grass are left to grow between crops called strip cropping. Project activity. 1. Make a project showing consumption and conservation of resources in your locality. 2. Have a discussion in the class, how to conserve various resources used in your school. 3. Imagine if oil supplies get exhausted, how this will affect your lifestyle. Multiple choice questions. 1. Everything available in our environment to satisfy our needs is termed as A. Technology B. Resource C. Natural vegetation D. None of these. 2. Resource planning is essential for existence of all forms of life. A. Ecological balance B. Sustainable C. Exploitation D. None of these three. Where was the first International Earth Summit held? A. Rio de Janeiro B. Geneva C. Switzerland D. Philippines 4. Which one of the following type of resources iron ore? A. Renewable B. Biotic C. Flow D. Non-renewable 5. In which one of the following states is terrace cultivation practiced? A. Punjab B. Plains of Uttar Pradesh C. Haryana D. Uttarakhand. Very short answer type questions. 1. What is a resources? Give two example. Answer: everything available in our environment which can be used to satisfy our needs, provided it is technologically accessible, economically feasible and culturally acceptable can be termed as resource. Coal, water, air, minerals etc. are some example of resource. 2. How can the resources be classified on the basis of origin? Answer: biotic and abiotic. 3. How can the resources be divided on the basis of exhaustibility? Answer: renewable and non-renewable. 4. Name any two states of India which are well endowed with solar energy. Answer: Gujarat and Rajasthan. 5. What is total geographical area of India? Answer: 328 million sq km. 6. What is wasteland? Answer: an unused area of land like rocky, arid and desert areas. 7. What is gross zone area? Answer: This represents the total zone area once or more than once in a particular year, that is, the area is counted as many as times as three all zones in a year. 8. What are biotic resources? Answer. These are obtained from biosphere and of life such as human beings, flora and fauna, fisheries, livestock, etc. 9. Name any two states where over-irrigation is responsible for land degradation. Answer. Punjab, Haryana. 10. Name any two crops associated with laterite soil. Answer. Tea and coffee. 11. What is wind erosion? Answer. Wind blows loose soil off flat or sloping land. This is known as wind erosion. 12. What is bad land? Answer. It is a land which is unsuitable for cultivation. Mainly soil erosion converts a fertile land into a bad land. 13. What is gully erosion? Answer. Gully erosion takes place when running water cuts deep ulins in the absence of vegetation. This type of erosion makes soil unfit for cultivation. 14. Which soils is the most widely spread in India? Answer. Alluvial soil. Short answer type questions. 1. What is stock? Give two examples. Answer. These are material in the environment which have the potential to satisfy the human needs, but could not be used as the human beings do not have the appropriate technology to convert them into usable form. For example, water, H2O, is a compound of two inflammable gases that has hydrogen and oxygen, but human beings do not have the required technology to use them as a source of energy. 2. Explain the role of humans in resources development. Answer. Resources are function of human activities. 2. Human beings interact with nature through technology and create institutions to accelerate their economic development. 3. Human beings transfer materials available in our environment into resources and use them. 3. What are reserves? Answer. Reserves are the subset of the stock, which can be put into use with the help of existing technical know-how, but their use has not been started. These can be used for meeting future requirements. River water can be used for generating hydroelectric power, but presently, it is being utilized only to a limited extent. Thus, the water in the dams, forests, etc. is a reserve which can be used in the future. 4. What are international resources? Answer. Resources which are found in a region, but have not been utilized due to lack of capital or other reasons. For example, the western parts of India, particularly Rajasthan and Gujarat, have potential for the development of wind and solar energy, but so far these have not been developed properly. 5. India is rich in certain types of resources but deficient in some other resources. Support your answer with example. Answer. The states of Jharkhand, Chhattisgarh and Madhya Pradesh are rich in mineral resources but lack industrialization. 2. Arunachal Pradesh has an abundance of water resources, but lacks an infrastructural development. The state of Rajasthan is very well endowed with solar and wind energy, but lacks in water resources. The cold desert area of Ladakh is relatively isolated from the rest of the country due to lack of means of transportation and communication. 3. Most of northeastern states are rich in natural vegetation but lacks in fertile soil. 6. Explain the major factors which are responsible for the formation of soil. Answer. Relief, parent rock or bedrock, climate, vegetation and other forms of life and time are important factors in the formation of soil. Edomate. 2. Various forces of nature such as change in temperature, actions of running water, wind and glaciers, activities of decomposers etc. contribute to the formation of soil. 3. Chemical and organic changes which take place in the soil are equally important. 4. Soil also consists of organic, humus, and inorganic materials. 7. Mention the criteria on the basis of which Indian soils can be classified. Answer. I. Factors responsible for soil formation. 2. Color. 3. Thickness. 5. Texture. VH. 6. Chemical and physical properties. 8. Mention the factors on which the land use pattern of India depends upon. Answer. The use of land is determined by physical as well as human factors. I. Physical factors, topography, climate and soil types. 2. Human factors, population density, technological capability, culture and traditions. Long answer type questions. 1. What is resource planning? Mention the steps which are involved in resource planning. Answer. Resource planning is a technique on skill of proper or judicious use of resource. Resource planning is a complex process which involves I. Identification and inventory of resources across the regions of the country. This involves surveying, mapping, qualitative and quantitative estimates and measurement of the resources. 2. Evolving a planning structure endowed with appropriate technology skill and institutional setup for implementing resources development plans. 3. Matching the resources development plans with overall national development plans. 2. Explain the classification of resources on the basis of exhaustibility. Answer. I. Renewable resources. Renewable resources are the natural resources which can be used again and again or can be reproduced by physical, mechanical and chemical processes. Solar energy, air, water and soil are some of the renewable resources of energy. 2. Non-renewable resources. Non-renewable resources are the natural resources that cannot be replaced at all or within a reasonable time. Fossil fuels such as oil, gas and coal are examples of non-renewable resources. These resources are accountable over millions of years. They are considered to be non-renewable resources because once they are used up, they are gone forever. 3. Explain the classification of resources on the basis of ownership. Answer. A. Individual resources. Resources which are owned by private individuals are known as individual resources. Plots, fields, houses, can book, etc. are some examples of individual resources. B. Community-owned resources. The resources which are accessible to all the members of the community are known as community resources. Village ponds, public park, playground, etc. are some examples of community resources. C. National resources. All the resources which are under the control of state or union government are known as national resources. All the resources within political boundaries are national resources because the government has the power to acquire even the private properties. D. International resources. These resources are owned and regulated by international institutions. The oceanic resources beyond 200 kilometers of the exclusive economic zone belong to the open ocean, and no individual country can utilize these without the convergence of international institution. India has got the right to money manganese nodules from the bed of the Indian Ocean from that area which lies beyond the exclusive economic zone. 4. Suggest any 3 measures of soil conservation. Answer. Proper farming techniques used for soil cultivation are I. Crop rotation. If the same crop is sown in the same field, year after year, this consumes certain nutrients from the soil, making it infertile. Crop rotation can check this type of erosion. 2. Settled agriculture. Checking and reducing shifting agriculture by persuading the tribal people to switch over to settled agriculture. 3. Terracing and contour bunding. Terracing and contour bunding across the hill slopes is a very effective and one of the oldest methods of soil conservation. Hill slope is cut into a number of terraces having horizontal top and steep slopes on the back and front. Contour bounding involves the construction of bank along the contour. 4. Strip cropping. Large fields can be divided into strips. Strips of grass are left to grow between the crops. This breaks, cop the force of the wind. This method is known as strip cropping. B. Shelter belt. Planting lines of trees to create shelter also works in a similar way. Such trees are called shelter belts. These shelter belts have contributed significantly to the stabilization of sand dunes and in establishing the desert in western India.